Brian, and I wanted to show you how to create a one-page website that's hosted in Amazon Web Services S3. So their simple storage solution. So here's an example of a web page that I have hosted right here on GitHub. So pretty simple page, some text, a graphic, some buttons, not much here. The actual files look like this, just four files, CSS, an icon, image, and an index page. So what we're going to do is log into Amazon Web Services and then go over here to Services Storage and you'll see S3. We're going to click on S3. There we go. And what we're going to do in the buckets area here is we're going to create a bucket. So click Create Bucket. And then you have to give the bucket a unique name for your region. Here's my region here, US West. So I'm going to call it something similar to what we're doing. So fun Filipino words and culture, like so. If you intend to eventually have it be a URL of its own, you can go ahead and just put that there. I'm going to uncheck block all public access. So now it's going to be accessible, at least the folder is, and I'll acknowledge what I've just done. No versioning, no tags, no encryption. I'll hit create bucket. Okay, good. Now I can see I've got a new bucket down here, fun Filipino words and culture.com. I'll click on that. And now I'm ready to upload some files. So let's go ahead and hit the upload button inside the folder or inside the bucket. I'll add files. Here's my four files. Upload. Okay, we haven't actually uploaded them yet. We're just kind of confirming, and you can change a couple things. So we're going to grant public permission to the files that we're uploading. So hit this grant public access and acknowledge. Now this is, we've already done this for the folder, but now we've done it for the files in the folder as well. And then let's click on properties. It may actually, okay, it's got the storage class. We're going to leave it as is standard, but if you wanted a lower level service, you could come in here and you could select one of those. No encryption, no tag, no metadata. I'm going to hit upload. And then after this uploads, we'll have one more step. So those all succeeded. See down there in the bottom, green. I'll hit close. Okay. Now the next thing is I want to actually, I just have a bucket. I've got files in the bucket. They're public, but it's not really set up for web page, hosting. So let's go over here to properties and then go to the bottom, pass the versioning tags, encryption, all that happy stuff. Way down here is static website hosting. It's currently disabled, so we'll click edit. We'll select enabled. And then it's asking me to confer or to put the name of the index file, so index.html. I could just double check index.html. I don't have an error document, don't have anything else. I'll hit save changes. So this should give us a URL now. So we're still in that properties tab, but it should be updated. Let's go check. Okay, so here's a new URL. You can see it's the name we gave it, fun Filipino words and culture.com, but it's got this the S3 stuff here. And it's hosted on Amazon now, so let's see if that's working. There you go. That's how quick that was. We're now hosting this website in Amazon AWS. And then if you wanted to do the next logical step would be to register, your domain and then go back into AWS and Route 53 and create the DNS records so that you could actually use that domain. If you found this interesting and helpful, please like and subscribe and share. Thanks.